Welcome, everyone. It's now time to suffer.
Oh
Because
boy.
we're about to enter into Mega Man X6. I have with me Grizz. I have CC here and Kit.
Hello. I have something as well.
Oh.
The Gotchard driver from Combinator Gotchard.
Oh, good, because we're I suspect we're gonna need to we need some derailing conversation to keep Zero sane through this one.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, I thought that you put you close up.
I actually remember getting this in school. I was so
And
disappointed.
yeah. Three weeks
Bet.
ago,
The Matrix
the
happened.
Space colony Eurasia was taken over by Sigma. Sigma hired a mysterious reploid, Dynamo. Dynamo led Eurasia into orbit around the Earth. Thus began the tragic Earth crisis. Maverick Hunter Zero, taking Earth's destiny into his own hands. One Bleploid made a crash attack against a furious space colony. It was a successful attack, and the space colony was destroyed. But the Earth was saved. Although the Earth was saved, the huge explosion seriously damaged it. As for the battle against Sigma. By the way, I hate this song, by the way. X and Zero defeated Sigma and narrowly escaped with their lives. However, only one were returned from the battle. A blue light, X, still gripping a familiar saber in his hand. 3 weeks later, at present,
X5's.
there's so much pollution and ruined Earth that the Reploids could barely work. And a man is. I hate this intro so much. Because this is not the original X6 intro. It is a full it was full on anime like there's one of the best things about that. All Japanese, all amazing.
Honestly. Oh, that's okay. CC's gonna inject some Japanese into it for us.
Yes. Can I put those on
Yep.
the same
Speaking of Japanese, now it's a question of whether or not they're going to use
Yeah, got
Japanese.
it.
You good?
That's his new gizmo.
Yes, it's the gacha driver.
Yes. From
As I
Combinator
was.
Gotchard.
Yes. So, as I
I
was
love
getting
it.
ready to say, we're going to see whether or not they actually have kept the Japanese dialogue for Mega Man X6. Otherwise, we're going to have to voice it.
Oh boy. Lovely.
Oh, there you go.
There's the Japanese dialogue.
Nice.
I actually kind of like Gates' design, I'll admit.
Yeah, Gates' design is really good.
It's neat. Lame name, though.
Yeah, it's pretty ba it is pretty basic. I'm in your stream hacking your drivers. I'm gonna turn up the game volume a little bit so we can hear
That's fair.
Gate.
それだけじゃない。何かが起ころうとしている。この胸騒ぎは一体。これを。何かの破片だな。ここで激しい戦いでもあったのか。一体どれだけの人間やレプリロイドが犠牲になったんだろう。 待てよ。これは。
これは。
これは。One week later.
Well, that didn't take long.
ついに完成したぞ。この冷静な僕が、あまりのことにおかしくなってしまいそうだ。
I'm going mad, and I absolutely love it.
Why? Yeah, sure.
今までこの僕の研究を理解すらできなかった。
Welcome to insanity. It really is fun here.
そう。この世の過当なレプリロイドたちすべてを僕の元に服従させるために。
Oh.
できる。できるぞ。
できるぞ。
この理想の世界。
この line delivery
を支配する素晴らしい世界が。
素晴らしい世界が。Great. Love that line delivery.
X.
X. X.
Why is there an
E?
E.
Why is there an E there?
Japanese. It's pretty obvious why there's an E there if you know. If you know how X is written out phonetically in katakana.
Yeah, this is one of the many hints that this game is just them doing a one-to-one translation without any localization.
Yeah. That seems that way, don't it? There is no one else is left to fight!
It begins.
Oh my
English,
God.
Our ability to speak is deteriorating. We need you, X. It's getting real bad up here.
That's amazing. Holy crap.
It
that's
begins. Funny. It has begun.
There is no one else is left to fight.
X? Oh no.
I'm reeling. That's funny. Oh, I can stop laughing. Oh no. Kit's clipping it.
I certainly hope so.
The moment I saw that. That's the greatest thing I've ever seen. Holy crap.
And it only gets better from here.
Oh boy.
Most of the mechanoids became mavericks. It's been a long time. Stay alert, X. I'll be fine since I have the armor and saber.
And armor and saber are capitalized.
Yes. Yeah. Since I fixed the falcon armor very quickly, the dash function is incomplete. So yeah,
because it was broken as hell. Because it was broken as hell in the last game, we decided to
nerf it.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, I will stop the mechanoids. Okay.
What?
Go to the.
What was that dialogue?
Go to the entrance of the ruins ahead.
This is all right then.
Oh, we don't even get ready.
Well,
you don't.
Emperor palette cleanser.
This game comes whether you're ready for it or not.
Evidently.
Yeah, so you have the beam. So you have the beam saber.
That is a nice touch. Very soothing for all the destruction. Like, why is it even called the Falcon Armor anymore? It's more like the Pigeon Armor.
That sounds
the
awesome.
Angry Penguin
Whoa.
Armor.
Angry
Penguin. Aw, man. You mean that we could have gotten armor based on freaking Chill Penguin? That would have been amazing.
Yeah.
Take my armor! It's cold!
Why didn't you shoot, X?
He's like, and like the guy who's being held by the mechanoid, like some reploid named Bill or whatever. He's like, oh yeah, thanks.
Yeah, that was from Mega Man Rise of Sigma.
The Day of Sigma is an amazing little anime. Yeah, this little episode. I rewatched that periodically. That was really good.
Yeah.
And I like their voice actors for the cast. It was before Sigma needed a cough drop to get through his day.
Of course, I'm evil. I talk like this.
There you are. Are you all right? Beyond here is a giant mechanoid. It's suddenly activated due to a radio wave problem. We are afraid and we got hurt. I'll take care of this. Return to the hunter base now. All right. It acts like it's possessed. Be careful.
You guys act like you don't know how the virus works by now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This is the introduction of something called the Zero Nightmare.
I'm being just real. I forget what a mechanoid even is.
Basically, just a really, really big, really, really big robot. industrial robot. Yeah.
Industrial reploid, yeah.
Big Maverick, gotcha.
Big.
Grug, no, activate. Grug, smash.
Grug, smash.
I am coming for you!
This is fun. I'm enjoying this.
I'm glad you're still having fun with it.
Interesting.
Oh my gosh, I just got pinged. I swear, it's like a law that in every furry server ever, they have to post the Big Balls music video every week.
There's the Zero Nightmare.
Man, it is a really funny music video.
Dude, you stole my kill!
EXT Hog. No wonder Zero's S rank.
My KD.
Do you want me to do Alia?
Go right ahead.
Zero?
And now who wants to voice this chunky dude that's coming in?
I guess I can.
Oh yeah, big boy over here.
I knew Zero was doing this.
Who are you?
Hi, Max. Hi, Max.
Hi.
You need a dog. Hi, you need a dog face desperately.
Hi, Aiden.
For real.
Yes. Sorry, I'm late.
You good?
Hi, Max.
I'm investigating the Zero Nightmare.
What? Did you say the Zero Nightmare?
What are you trying to do?
Running around in your underwear, chasing him with his own Z Saber. It's very weird, very psychosomatic.
What is your connection to the Zero Nightmare?
What about Zero? Are you behind this?
You are dangerous. I'll dispose of you.
This move. I swear, this guy. This move.
I don't know what he actually tries to say. He just sounds like he's saying disco.
I always thought it sounded like he was saying this move and then doing an attack. he forgot to name it, but he still had to call it out like anime rules.
I wish I could hear it so I could figure it out.
Maverick Hunter. Not amazing.
Oh, I'll turn up the volume next time I fight Hymax.
We will destroy the Zero Nightmare. You are not wanted here. Keep out.
I need to turn up the volume anyway because there is going to be a cutscene coming up. I could not inflict any damage on him. Hi, Max. The Zero Nightmare? Did I dream about Zero? What is happening?
Was Zero naked in my dream?
You have that one too?
You have that one too.
Shit. It's magical. The air is so quiet, and the window flies open.
I was literally thinking that is straight up just the king of all.
Naito Mea.
I'm calling it. Reploids made with facial hair are evil. That's like just like their design specs.
Yeah. The other idea is that Isaac here is also Wily.
Okay.
We'll never find Dr. Wowie or the Meteo.
How many other Wilies are there?
So, Kit, who's looming behind you as you loom behind me?
Reploido.
Grizz.
No, not Grizz. The border of the gate.
Oh, gate. Gate. Yeah, that's gate. He's a scientist. Old besties with Alia.
Space Corony. Reploido. This guy's hamming it up.
There's always the risk when you put a microphone in front of ideologues. Getting Erebus vibes from this guy.
I'm kind of spitting though.
Irregular Hunter Zero.
At least doesn't talk like a tiny little baby. That's a much better breath,
though. Let him cook.
Let him finish his story. I love when he shit talks Zero.
He's just getting to the good part.
Yeah.
And to delete the Zero's ghost.
Wow.
So now Zero has gone from being straight up this guy's name to his title.
Now,
apparently.
What the fuck kind of name is Hi-Max? I know that's like...
And they refer to him as this Hi-Max. He refers to him as this Hi-Max. So, also titled, apparently now.
Yeah, there's more than one?
Look, Aiden, don't overthink it. This entire game is really good designs implemented by people with serious head trauma.
Yeah, and...
I don't remember making a game.
pretty much you can tell that this game is a one-to-one translation with absolutely no localization.
Not even a good one-to-one translation. It has a lot of issues.
Yes.
Yeah. No, it's like Google Translate before Google Translate.
They translated the smoke signal sent from Japan.
Well, I do like this music.
How dare!
How dare!
About Zero that way.
Yeah, they don't really explain it well in this, but the idea is that cyberspace and real space are becoming kind of impermeable. Or permeable, excuse me. They're kind of blending.
Okay.
That's not possible? Like, what is this Digimon bullshit?
Oh, by the way, here's another glorious line. No, due to a strong jamming.
Wow.
Raspberry.
I can't look
Only
into
one
it from
man
here.
Would dare give me the raspberry.
X, you have to see this shit. He is busting a move.
So I've got to go in there blind.
There needs a comma. That needed a comma.
I forget the Oxford comma. These people need grade school commas.
Yeah.
I'm definitely digging the music though.
You know, the high school I went to kind of, well, actually no, the entire school district I went, public school district I went to kind of demanded you use Oxford commas. But it was weird going from that to college where I was like, they were like, no Oxford commas.
It's that's honestly just an opinion thing. Anyone who says there's like an authoritative way to do it's talking out their butt.
Yeah.
I prefer to use Oxford commas. It makes more sense to me.
The investigators to investigate the nightmare phenomena. But considering the situations of the Maverick Hunters, you are the only hunter who could accomplish these difficult missions. As we've lost Zero, you are our only hope. Can you do it, X?
I'll do it!
I've just obtained a report on the nightmare areas and their investigators sent to the areas. However, the details of the situations in the areas are still unknown. Oh, wow, there's wording here. Due to bad radar transmission.
Yes, due to
that's
a
not
ba-
the only, that's,
yes, due to you know, due to
oh my gosh.
Yes, you know, due to a strong jamming.
Strong damage.
they're really busting it down. They're
also,
throwing it back.
In our case, any changes occur in the nightmare area, I'll show you by a red signal. It's difficult to predict what the wording's going to be. What the changes are, though.
That's okay. I'll know when I get there. Yeah, the problem is, though, is that they give no indication of anything in this game.
Oh, good lord.
I will discover what the nightmares are and what Izok's intentions are.
Wait, what? Intentions was spelled wrong. What?
Who's Cygnus? God. Forgot who's Cygnus. I forgot.
I'm Cygnus.
Quick, dude. Damn. That. With how fast he's scrolling through it, I can barely pay attention.
Intentions was spelled wrong.
I didn't say that.
Hey, Kit, can you snag that clip, please?
It was...
Mm-hmm.
It was... So it was spelled as if it was... Not intention, but in... Put at the start of the word tension as in, you know, stress or whatever.
Oh, intention?
Yeah!
Video games are awesome.
Don't put yourself too hard, X. Remember, you are our only hope. Roger.
Oh, you wait for Kit to come back.
Oh, I'll just keep going. I was gonna say, I know Kit's trying to clip the thing so that we can get the picture of it.
Oh, God.
Man's a little broke. Man's a little broken.
What is it, Alia? Nothing. Just be careful. Some Reploids may accept what Izok says is true and comes to the nightmare areas. If you find them, secure them and send them to the Hunter base. The Reploids you have rescued can be surveyed here by pressing the R1 button.
The nightmare areas, if you will.
And who wants to
be Douglas? The nightmare areas, yes.
Because I think...
I can't even see what Douglas looks like, but I'll do it. Fuck.
Big nerd, like big green nerdy dude.
Giant nerd.
Hey, what?
Egon from Ghostbusters.
Sorry,
Egon from
clipping.
Ghostbusters. Oh God, forgive me, Harold Ramis.
Were you able to get the image
and you,
kit?
Mm-hmm.
And if you obtain any items, I'll process them into parts that you can use.
Very good deckhand.
You can equip the parts with the L1 button.
Good luck, Gex. Okay, so here are the first ones. We have Commander Yamark, Rainy Turtloid, Shield Sheldon, Blizzard Wolffang.
Let's go!
That man's name was not Shield Sheldon. I refuse to believe that man's name was fucking Shield Sheldon.
That is not silly. That is far from the silliest thing about that individual.
Yeah. Ground Skarovich, Metal Shark Player.
Metal Shark Player?
Infinity Maginian. And Blaze Heatmix.
Blaze Heat.
They get a little fast and loose.
I'm feeling like how Collector did when he saw how Intentions was spelled. What the fuck?
Yeah.
You know what? I don't know whether this is kind of weird or not, because I'm usually really not into like insectoid characters, but I think Commander Yamrak's cute.
Commander Yamrak's cool.
Speaking of which, I'm trying to figure out where to go to first, because it's been a really long time since I played this.
What the Twitch embed? Why does Twitch do that?
Did anyone give us a list? Or is it your choice?
CC, do you know any of these guys' weaknesses? Because you can pick if you want to do, if you're doing, if we want to do
it. I have no idea.
Okay, why don't you pick them?
Hey, CC, do you mind not playing with your Kamen Rider stuff right up on the mic?
Alright.
Try to blow up my eardrums, man.
Because Central Museum is going to be a pain in the ass because that one is RNG.
Ugh, that's right.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah, that's obnoxious.
I'm sorry, but RNG is like the worst thing for any like Mega Man game straight up ever.
Yeah, because this is very much so a game that requires like precision jumping and a little bit of skill, and when you throw RNG in there, you kind of fuck all that up.
Yeah, you know what exactly. I'm actually going to do? I'm going to head to the Weapon Center first, because then I'm going to head to the Weapon Center first, so then I can get Zero.
Yay.
So I can go after the Zero Nightmare. Because Infinity Maginian has an easier way to going it, because each stage has a separate section in it. Oh, by the way, welcome to the final countdown.
No.
Hey, oh my gosh.
No. This is the largest final countdown, yeah.
Oh, wow.
It straight up is.
Yeah, I'm expecting Job to come dancing out with like a sword or something.
Yeah. What's that? What? What's that huge Reploid? You are in the Weapon Center. They have been constructing powerful weapons without the appropriate approvals.
OSHA violation. The OSHA hunters.
A huge Reploid.
They haven't filed their permit. Execute them.
I suppose it's Illumina.
Like Illuminati?
Considering that I couldn't pick up any reading of its activation, it must be a nightmare. There has to be cables which they're sending energy to Illumina. I always called it just Lumina before, but it's Illumina. Find and destroy them. Good luck.
You'll be partnering with Agent J.C. Denton.
Good luck. Wow.
By the way, that's the thing that is going to be really irritating.
Oh, you see boy. This, yeah, you saw this. Hitting.
You see the squid dudes?
Yeah.
They get very much worse.
If they make contact with a Reploid that's floating there, then kiss that character goodbye. And any power-ups that he might give, any things that he might present, he's just gone for good.
Yep.
You just get to watch a poor, helpless civilian get absolutely just shredded.
This whole level's giving me, like, 90s X-Men vibes. Hulk mutant.
Yeah, Illumina's just straight up a freaking,
Sentinel.
Yeah.
Oh,
This level is such bullshit.
It's in the same way that Neon Tigers is that, like, My Michelle by Guns N' Roses.
Why do I hear a sound from the phone?
Yeah, that's the eye laser.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really a really irritating sound.
Yes, it is.
We're leaving forever.
It's kind of like a microwave from hell.
Which is interesting because I think this game could also be described as microwave in head or head in microwave simulator.
Ooh.
Like X7 is like bad, but at least it's like not just like seemingly artificially difficult.
Yeah.
With just really lazy and bizarre choices.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it does have some bizarre choices. Like, it's a Mega Man game that moves at a snail's pace.
You know what I mean? That's one of the reasons why, even with everything that happens here. Ow. Even with everything that happens here, I still consider X7 to be worse, because it's boring.
Yeah,
I mean,
I think...
Go ahead, Kit.
Oh, I was just going to say, I guess it's just your preference on would you rather be bored, or would you rather be, like, tearing hair out?
Yeah, I'd rather be tearing hair out, because at least that's something. That's a feeling.
Yeah.
Now, 7 does have some interesting ideas, like the ability to swap between players during a mission. So
yes, I do like that. X8 really nailed that one, perfected it.
Yes. But it also had stupid things like X just choosing not to fight, and you're kind of just stuck with Axel and Zero for 2/3 of the game.
I'm better off just leaving.
I hate that fucking noise!
Yeah,
it
man,
is
it
obnoxious.
It do kind of be like that though.
I'm sampling it for my next album.
So yeah.
You do music, Grizz?
I do. Yes.
Oh, that's cool. What kind? Or just in
general? Oh, it's the type that goes. Woo! No, I'm kidding.
Yeah,
it is more electronic.
Yeah, he does computer go. He does the audible version of computer go burr.
Yeah.
Can't wait for your newest album. Burr. Just 10 minutes of sustained whatever the fuck that noise is.
He does some pretty interesting experimental stuff. Interesting experimental stuff. Like, it's not a... So... That might be too experimental, though. That might be too experimental.
There is no such thing. Oh! If any of you are interested, though, my music is called Dr. Segway. That's artist name. Whatever.
I'll just do this right now. If I died, I'll die game over. I'll see if I had actually gotten any parts from these guys. Then that'll actually help me out a bit.
That'd be good.
Yeah, at least there's that.
Yeah, but the problem is, though, if they get caught by any of the nightmares, then... If they get captured by any of the nightmares, then they're gone for good. And any item that you can get from him... Any item that you can get from them, you can never get that back.
And some of them are pretty darn important.
Like, I believe there's one in... I believe that there is one in... trying to remember.
Starting to kind of grate on me now, yeah.
There you go, just brute force this SOB. How are you supposed to dodge that last one?
Nice.
There. Please tell me the thing is up there. Yes.
There it is.
Let's go.
Woo 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 woo.
Step into the Terminator 2 Judgment Day teleportation sphere.
Well, at least he kept his clothes on.
Uh-oh.
God damn. Alright, Morty X. Alright, Morty X. You look like you're cosplaying as a Gundam.
He does, don't he?
You gotta obtain all four of these programs, Morty X, so that the armor will be complete. I'm trying to mix it up a little bit here, how these capsules work. You like it?
You did that the last game, and it's kind of shit.
Shut up, Morty X. I'll remotely turn you off. We've established that I'm an AI now. I can do all kinds of crazy shit. Cyberspace and the real world are merging. It's like Digimon, Morty X. I'm Digimon, Dr. Light. The one I gave you now is the arm thing, the arm program for the blade armor. With your weapon charged fully, hold my hand and look me in the eye, essentially.
Sorry?
Hold the up button and press the shoot button. Then you can attack.
I need that. You can attack with charged blade.
Do what, Chris?
I need that clipped for shoot do alone.
Do the shoot do. You can do it, Morty X. You can do the shoot do.
I missed intentionally because there was a heart container behind it.
We saw. Wow, all these unique and interesting characters that you need to save are literally the same person.
Yeah, they're all
the same.
How did they get away with the stage's music literally just being Final Countdown?
It's literally just Final Countdown. We see back then copyright laws weren't a thing.
That's bullshit.
You're bullshit.
I know, that's what Hollywood said, and that's why we have so much problems with making YouTube videos nowadays.
Yeah, there was a fucking dude on top. There was a nightmare on top of a fucking hostage. And it grabbed him right before I died. So I had no shot of saving him.
Well.
Shoot.
I don't know.
So if I ever want to 100% this game, I would just have to reset the entire. I just have to reload my last save.
You just have to bleach the console at this point. It's the only way you're gonna get 100%, man.
There you go, my Discord borked the other embed.
Drunk Dr. Light ascends to Digimon and X gets the shoot do.
I'm not ready.
Yeah, the rails seem like super finicky.
Damn it, I lost him too.
That's what he sounds like.
For real.
I'm beyond angry at losing those guys. I don't know what I'm losing, it's been so fucking long.
You're losing the will to live.
Yeah, see, they're all gone.
That's a constant for this level, though.
Not even the final countdowns can save you from the shit.
For real, Eurobop can only go so far.
I got all the nightmares from them, so...
Yeah, I don't mind a game being hard, but like, if it's patently unfair, that's whole. It's just lame.
Yeah, happily this boss is pretty easy though.
Infinity Maginity. Oh no.
His flamboyant laughter.
What do you think you're doing?
Zero. Where is Zero?
You don't need to know that.
My color palette is weird. It is you who will be eliminated. What?
It's you who will be
eliminated.
I didn't
even say anything about eliminating.
Warida.
It's interesting, his own, Zero's own sword is his weakness, which is interesting.
Zero carried his weakness with him wherever he went, so his enemies could never get it.
I do like this music. I don't mind them reusing this. I don't mind them reusing it.
Oh, that's nice, it drops you right here.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised. Because honestly, it would send you to like the beginning of the second half originally.
Right. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Thank God it didn't.
It's me, Zero, but I've got a flamboyant laugh now.
Zero.
What are you doing?
I'm waiting for him to teleport behind you and go, oh, why am I moving? Shindeyu.
So, Japanese is such a really interesting language because I was watching a video talking about how one single subtlety that doesn't translate to English that may change a lot of implications for Final Fantasy VII is that Sephiroth uses the phrase Watari, I think, referring to himself. But it's also got kind of like a plural connotation, so it's like him and Genova. But it turns out that in the Final Fantasy VII remake, after Sephiroth does his, you know, spoiler shenanigans, he stops saying Watari and starts speaking in a more classically singular word.
Well, that's interesting.
Yeah, so people are wondering, like, what that implies. Because the other thing that was interesting was one of the designers mentioned how Cloud's headaches are Genova overriding his perceptions and memories. And looking back at it, before Sephiroth goes berserk, he gets a splitting headache. So it's kind of raising questions about who's in charge of who. Nice.
I decided not to try and bull rush him.
Oh, you chipped my nail.
He's gotta find Zero. They died before they could smooch.
For real.
And now, boom, the real Zero shows up.
Oh yeah, this is classic.
My reputation has been damaged while away. Being thought of as... Wait, this is
apparently,
you don't need to read out the lines for this, since it's voiced.
We get it.
I'm aware, I just think it's fun.
No, it's alright, Zero, you're my toy!
Heck, not out loud!
Bro, cut you in half! Laser chest!
Bro literally annihilated you.
That is most unfortunate.
There it is! I hit myself while I tried to repair myself.
As you can see, I did not do a very good job on my own language for my own language program.
So yeah, you got a few things to patch out still, but you know, I'm getting.
I'm missing a considerable chunk of my frontal lobe. Hey Dan.
Oh, that's hey, so Dan. Real.
It was so.
Listening to...
Yeah. I hit myself while I repaired myself.
Yeah, you missed the best line in gaming history. Oops. But don't worry, Kit's clicking it for you.
What am I fighting for?
This is like the best X-Force episode of hell.
Yeah, this one's actually pretty good.
Yeah, where the fuck were they getting off making X sound like a small child?
X always sounded like a small child, but this is considerable.
These are the best voices these two characters have ever had. Like, seriously.
I love that shot, though. I love that. I actually love that picture.
It is really good, yeah.
And then they eat.
Clear time!
Oh. Found a mysterious
item. They explained it.
Yeah. Related to the nightmare, it's basically a nightmare. Basically, these are the things that you... The orbs I've been collecting, they basically determine your rank.
Wow. Wait, where the hell is Infinity Machine Young?
I went into the other because each stage has its own separate area that has its specific boss. Like, for example, now that I've beaten Zero, or Nightmare Zero, I'm going to... Next boss that would appear will be Hymax.
Okay. What is a Majinyun, anyway? What is that?
You got me.
BRB, chat. I need to hide myself while I repair myself.
I think Majinyun is like a small little I think it's like a I'm trying to remember. It's like
it's a type of water flea, if I recall.
The water flea.
I need to ask you something. Will you help X carry out the missions?
No.
I did my job. I am a Maverick Hunter. I have been away for a while. I am ready to fight for peace. so now the nightmare stuff is starting to appear.
I hid as long as I could and I repaired as long as I could. I gotta fight, I guess. But seriously, the logic of how Zero survived in this game might as well literally have just been, you know, reasons.
Just reasons.
As you do.
Zero, where have you been? Oh, I'm sorry, man. My side hoe was pestering me.
He just comes back with, like, sunglasses and, like, a Hawaiian shirt and, like, a straw hat.
Yeah.
He's like, geez, you guys really goes to shit every time I go away for a while, huh?
That's the last time I take vacation.
Now I'll play a Zero.
The Z-Buster in this game. The Z-Buster in this game is insane.
Yeah, the Z-Buster in this is incredibly broken.
Randall Yamarat.
What did you say, Dan?
What did I say?
You said something.
I don't remember.
that's a feeling.
Oh,
Zero
man.
Comes back, hey, I'm sorry, man. My girlfriend texted me saying she's pregnant and it's mine. I had to bail out.
Oh,
I repaired myself.
Hey, good, you got your glasses back, Dr. Light.
Morty Zero. I'm so glad to see you again, Morty Zero. How are you doing, Morty Zero? You're way cooler than Morty X, Morty Zero, but don't tell him I said that.
I will never die.
Wow, okay, Morty Zero. You're like so cool and like so edgy. Wow.
I don't really remember, but when I came to, I could move. I don't know if the recovery function worked.
You don't know if it worked while you're literally recovered, Morty Zero? Is that what you just said to me?
Yeah, the problem, the entire problem with this scenario is he says he doesn't know how he recovered, but there's one particular maverick who has a special ability that would explain freaking what happened to Zero. It's freaking Metal Shark Player. Because when you fight Metal Shark Player, he has the ability to revive the corpses of former mavericks. So they can easily just say, hey, Metal Shark Player, revive the body of Zero so that we can use it for our plans. And that's what happened. And that's what freaking happened.
Yeah, that would have worked. Yeah,
but they never explain it. They never use that explanation, even though it makes perfect sense.
Dr. Light says that like it's a perfectly normal thing.
The world still needs Morty X and you, Morty Zero. So you came back to life, didn't you? It's literally the world's tears. Morty Zero, the world just really likes you. We must put an end to this nightmare. Please give Morty X his armor upgrade. I didn't make one for you, Morty Zero. I don't like you that much. There's a reason I call you Morty Zero. It's not because you're like the original. However, for like a security reason, Morty Zero.
Yeah, for security reason. Not a security reason. It's just security reason.
The armor won't work until all four programs combine. Now I will give Morty X a foot program of the blade armor. This upgrade will enhance Morty X's dash performance and enable him to do some really sick shit. Morty Zero. He'll be busting it down sexual style, Morty Zero. Morty X can dash while jumping, and Morty X will be invincible in the beginning of time. Just beginning of time, for as long as he's in the book of Genesis.
It's just retroactive.
As long as he's in the book of Genesis, he's fine.
Yeah, oh, fuck.
For the Earth and for the future. Good luck, 40-0. Dr. Light, got a bunch of Pokemon to cry over your corpse, did you, Morty Zero?
You know, the, it's weird, Nate.
Take the board, 48.
It's weird that they reanimated his sword completely.
Yeah, they made it look more like a lightsaber instead of a laser katana, and that's just kind of lame.
Well, to be fair, it's a lot easier to dash cancel now.
Zero with the tech.
Excuse me. Oh, goodness.
Yeah. All right.
CC, you've been kind of quiet. Is your audio doing okay? You've been talking?
Yeah, it's fine. I haven't been talking.
Oh, okay. I guess I just know you had that glitch the other day.
Yeah, that was annoying. I hated that.
He just doesn't want to interrupt the magnificent Dr. Light Rick.
Drunk Dr. Light is certainly going to be the highlight of this game.
I'm trying to put all my Gotcha crap away.
Yeah, you got a lot of it. I'd imagine that would take a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's literally going to be putting shit away until the end of time with how much Gutthard shit he has.
So many cards. So many cards.
Man. Hearing you talk about your cards is reminding me of when I was in the Magic the Gathering in college.
You went to Magic the Gathering college?
Yes,
which color did you major in?
unironically, I majored in white.
Nice.
Because I'm a basic bitch. But no, I had a professor who's really cool, and I still see him. He's since stopped being a professor and moved on to another career, so I occasionally see him during my job. But he got me into Magic, me and several other students, and we would all play Magic the Gathering. And we specifically played Commander. And the deck I always majored in, I called it Shirtless Buff Dudes Flexing on Walls. Because the commander's ability was like, you had to pay to hit me. Like, you had to tap a certain amount of mana just to hit me. That was the commander's whole thing. So I decided I was going to build a bunch of... I was going to build a deck around having walls while also having things to bolster my ranks to discourage people from attacking me. So in the early game, I was everyone's favorite whipping boy, but if anyone ever decided to stop focusing on me and give me time to cook, then I could just muster a force of walls to keep people from hitting me, as well as a bunch of little jobbers that can just pile on top of you.
Hell yeah.
It was interesting.
Yep.
I'm not very... So I've played Magic off and on for years, but I'm not very good at it. I remember a few years ago, I had a friend who was hosting Commander, and he had us submit the names and lists for our decks. Just, he was curious. And before I had even posted the card list, I think the deck was named Furries and Robots.
Yeah.
And like, he put in our group chat before I even like put the card list, he goes, kid's coming.
Yeah, kid's coming.
Amazing.
The two things that you can use to make up Kit's entire personality, furries and robots.
Yeah.
For real.
I didn't have Grizz playing Mega Man 2 around the same time he learned to walk or anything.
That
Grizz, you're old enough to walk, so you're old enough for this. Just Mega Man 2 in front of little toddler Grizz.
Mega Man 2, damn, that's kinda harsh.
Actually, I think you started on 10, because it had an easy mode that was rather merciful.
Yeah.
By Mega Man standards, anyway.
Admittedly, don't remember that, because
I should not have gone to Commander Yanmar stage.
But I think one of my earliest memories with Mega Man is, first hearing the theme to the, you know, Dr. Wily Stage 1 Mega Man 2. That, like, altered my brain chemistry for good.
It sticks with you.
But the second thing that I remember is, you remember when I built the Yellow Devil out of Lego?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, which for the record was extremely easy.
Yeah, it still turned out well.
You just need a lot of yellow pieces.
Exactly, I was fortunate enough to have so many.
You just need one angry eye. And the best part is, if you drop it and it breaks apart, that's like a feature, not a bug.
Yeah, feature, not a bug.
Oh boy, the lighting is sure helpful.
Yeah, no wonder why I've liked Mega Man so much then.
Yeah, and I think it's not like I like forced it. He always took a lot of interest in the games I was playing, and you know, periodically I did my classic run throughs.
Yeah. I think my, like, very first most memory with it, though, is, like, I think I was four. You had the X collection on GameCube, of all things, which, let's go. And
yes.
I think you were playing X4. You were on, you know, like, the stairs, Split Mushroom or whatever.
Yeah.
I remember Split that. Mushroom, I think that's my very first, like, Mega Man memory ever.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. And then I remember you had me playing Battle and Chase, of all things, which, good guess game, but you know.
It was pretty fun.
I feel a strong power. Is this an investigator? Yeah, I'm talking about Commander Yanmark. Nothing much else to say there.
She's not very hard, but I do think she's cute.
Hmm.
So now let's murder her.
What's the voice, Commander Yanmark?
one.
Who wants to make the most uncute character?
Hey, you're the nightmare investigator.
Oh wait, that's zero. I jumped the gun. I had too good an idea.
Who wants to voice?
So you sound like some...
By the way, who wants to voice Zero? Because I voiced X.
Chris, you did him earlier.
I know I did last time, but didn't someone before, or should I voice Zero?
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Alright. Commander Yemmerich?
Yeah, I'm in charge of the Amazon area. Tell me, what'll you do with the nightmare?
Are you serious? It is your silly toy. And your Watto voice.
Yeah, oh boy. Oh boy, now I'm self-conscious. I was trying to go for like Jersey, like smoke 12 packs a day.
Maverick Gunners and Riploid Researches. Yeah, y'all liars.
I had the chili dog with that.
I may end up betrayed and deleted. I'm walking here. So I'll delete you first.
So I'll delete you first.
Yeah, Dan, you do that better.
Conversations have no context. They're rhyme or reason.
Now, this boss music I do enjoy.
Dan, we want to talk about people who have good voiceovers. Dan is really amazing.
Oh, Dan kills it.
Man, if I had a better microphone.
Wow.
That was... holy crap.
The fuck was that?
Just cut like that bitch butter. In half.
Cut like
all butter. All right.
You fuck that bitch up.
Jeez.
I'm collecting the nightmares. Now no one will have bad dreams.
Thanks, Kirby.
Yamar option. Dragonfly is to fly around you and defend.
I'm collecting all the nightmares.
He now has the Yanma Pokemon.
Yanma. Commander Yurik. I'll delete you for... Oh, fuck. Never mind. Explode.
Life up, energy up, super recover, leg part three. Commander Yamark, an ex-investigator of the Amazon area. He was a Reploid created for the danger...
Wait, that's a dude? I didn't... Okay. Interesting.
He was a Reploid created for the Nature Preservation Project. He burnt the forest by control disorder.
He burnt the forest...
By control disorder.
Control disorder.
I'm pretty sure they're trying to go. He burnt the force by
control. Point of disorder.
I don't know what they mean.
I'm pretty sure they were trying to say like controlled burning.
Yeah.
He wasn't accused of the incident. But someone altered Yamar's flying system. He crashed and died. He was created by my colleague, Gate.
Wait, he died, but then he, like, got better in time for Zero to fight him? What?
Yeah, well, I mean, Zero got better.
Oh.
I like Yamarek. I have no shade on cute. Not shade on cute, dudes.
Well, yeah, considering who you're dating.
Oh no, I've always found Reploids and Mavericks to just be, like, kind of gender neutral. Just whatever the fuck you want them to be. Go crazy.
Yeah, I mean, they are machines, they probably is just a matter of determination.
Yeah. That's how I've seen it. It's not Chill Penguin Man, it's just, you know, Chill Penguin.
Yeah.
If that makes sense, I don't know.
Yeah, Izok actively praises Zero, the idea of him being wily. But they don't actually pull the trigger on it. By the way, you know what doesn't help? Is that Izok sounds exactly like freaking Shocker. Like the person who control... Like the guy in control of Shocker from Kamen Rider.
Might be the same actor.
Are we gonna chase him down to the end of the year?
So I was telling CC this the other day. For some reason, I love English words said in a Japanese accent. I don't know why, I just do.
I do too, it's fun.
Izok.
前のゼロに対するこだわりは少し異常ではないか。
No, no, I'm not into zero. I don't have posters all over my room.
You are.
They don't have little kissy face, little kissy marks on them. That's you made that up. Slander.
I totally didn't Photoshop all of Zero's clothes off and then Photoshop his undies on.
99.98% の確率でレプリロイドを落とし入れています。I saw his picture confirmed.
Smile. My headcanon do not steal.
ではそろそろ次の段階に移す。
It's not like I like you or anything, Baka.
アイゾックよ。は。
あの二人のイレギュラーハンター、念のため監視しておけ。目を
仰せのままに。
じゃあ、over here, I got
it. I'm gonna head back to the Amazon area because, unlike other times where I beat everyone and then try to find things, I'm better off just taking the opportunity to search.
I gotcha.
See if there's anybody
it's not
else
like I like Zero-chan or anything, stupid Baka.
Who is Zero-chan? You obviously fail.
Zero-chan.
I'm tempted to tell a story about Grizz, but I don't want to embarrass you.
Frickin'.
Zero-chan.
What's the story?
the Mace Windu story.
What?
Oh, do you not even remember that?
Yeah, yeah message me. I don't no idea what you're talking about.
Okay.
Hold on. What?
The Mace Windu story. We're gonna hear some excellent Grizz.
Yeah, even I'm curious now. What are you talking
yeah,
about?
Even Grizz wants to hear this story because he, as far as we know, hasn't experienced it.
Yeah, sorry.
I can't remember how old you were, so... I can't remember how old you were, so... Like...
Sorry, I was having an out-of-body experience while it was happening.
Those Flintstone gummies started hitting a little different.
True. I had three instead of two.
Man's about to see through time.
I got fucked up.
Dude, I gotta tell you. So, medical cannabis has been, like, one of the most consistently helpful things with my chronic stomach stuff. Like, helps with pain, helps with nausea. Mm-hmm. But there was one time they royally screwed my dose up.And I tripped balls for almost an entire day.
Oh, jeez.
I was orbiting Saturn for a while.
Wow.
Like,
spins are not fun.
Like, I remember my sister even came in and she was standing in the hall. You know, I could just sort of hear her in the distance. And she said to my mom, too bad you're not recording this. We could have made $10,000. So apparently I yelled at the top of my lungs, son of a bitch!
You finally came down from orbiting Saturn when you heard about how you lost the opportunity for $10,000.
Yeah, and my mom said I would like go back and forth between like giggling and like crying. And apparently at one point I'm like, I don't like this. One of my hands is way bigger than the other one. This needs to stop right now.
Oh my god.
Okay, what the hell? I've taken so many shots at you, kid. Tell the Mace Windu story. What the hell?
Okay, I was just finished typing it. One time, he was telling my dad all these facts about Mace Windu from Star Wars because I think we had just seen because you were really into the prequels at the time.
Yeah.
And
I was young then.
Yeah, yeah. So it was definitely a while ago.
Yeah.
So you're going through like all these facts, and my dad goes, "Wow, you must really, really like Mace Windu." And you got all indignant. You went, "I am not into Mace Windu. I just like the purple lightsaber."
It's not like I like Mace Windu Chan or anything.
Wow. Okay. Then.
It's not like I like Samuel L. Jackson, Sean.
I don't care what anyone says.
This is great because you're just like so. You're just it was like getting caught. Like it was like getting. It was just great.
I enjoy playing as Zero. The problem is, though, is that they reduced Zero's freaking defense. Like, it's going to reach a point... Like, it does reach a point where a lot of players who play as Zero just choose black armor... Just use the cheat code to get black armor Zero.
Isn't there a way to get black armor Zero without the code in this one? Isn't there, like, a...
No, I think, it's, like only, I think it's only code.
Okay, I couldn't remember. Like, most of the Mega Man games, I know most of the secrets, but I'm only willing to subject myself to so much of this one. Can't wait till we get to the level with the evil donut.
I'm not mad, I'm just incredibly furious and also extremely disappointed that that was the noise they chose to go with.
Not even giving you a chance.
Damn.
That's what the S in S-Class Hunter is for. It's for suck it.
That's what Mance gets for leaking my music track early.
No, that doesn't look sanitary. I get a doctor to look at that.
He wants to be infected with Virginian.
What you did?
You heard wrong. I hid myself and repaired myself. You are one of the investigators for the nightmares. Aren't you? Period instead of question mark.
And the other investigators. Useless fleas? I'm sorry, this sludge is fucking up my brain, man. I'm literally orbiting Pluto right now.
You and me,
bro. That's the only explanation as to why I have to clean up their messes. But wait, why are you here anyway? Don't tell me. You destroyed my sweet Illumina.
Nobody tell that guy to turn around.
I know, right?
I have no peripheral vision, so I literally and I cannot move.
I didn't.
My map.
No, it's just fine.
My head is straight out of frickin'. My inability to turn my neck is straight out of Batman 89.
My inability to turn my neck is straight out of Big Ed from My New Day Fiancé.
I was thinking Grunt from Halo.
Maverick, I haven't even tested her. And I was thinking that I'll destroy all the thick-headed so-called authority with her. You will die.
Welcome, X-Men, to die.
I am Magneto. Welcome to die.
Guys, to destroy all the authorities? What are the odds this guy hasn't paid income tax in like 20 years? He's got his own little compound.
Don't look into my tax statement.
Please He's got
don't.
his house has like a big banner that says no step on snack.
No step on snack. No
and
step on snack.
Once the creator video king called Snack King.
good music at least. X6 saw Gemini Man and thought, why only two?
Well, yes, we saw Gemini Man and we thought, hey, why don't we do that, but we're...
True.
there's a mashup of this boss theme that I occasionally listen to. It's really, really good. I wonder if I already posted it. So I might have recommended it to Game Cobra. Oh yeah, I did, but I'll repost it.
Kit.
Yeah.
Do not look at what I sent you in DMs, or else literally all of your thoughts will be totally derailed.
Is it really? Oh boy.
Look in the DMs, look in the DM, and then share it with the rest of us.
Yep, exactly.
I think I'll succumb to peer pressure. How dare you? Of course I will.
I'll exclusively make you succumb to peer pressure.
Oh, I am going to keep zoning out forever now. Oh, wow.
You broke the man. You broke him.
Good.
He blowed up.
I heard with the thing in the X. Pew, pew, pew.
Pew, 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 ka-choo.
You do the shoot do.
I'm going to be here.
Yeah, you did the shoot do.
I'm gonna be here. It's okay. My brain.
Ray Arrow.
My brain function. No.
Ren. Ren. What the fuck was that noise, kid?
What the you walked in.
Hello, Ren.
Good timing.
Infinity an image that broke his brain.
Ren, you walked into the shoot do. That's what you
Infinity Machinian, ex test pilot for large weapons. He had a special party that could process at a high speed. He ignored the test program, choosing instead to go on schedule. Yeah, it says on schedule instead of own schedule. They forgot the W.
Oh no!
He produced excellent results, but he always had trouble with the other staff. Even Gate was unable to control him. One day he was disposed of by making it look like an accident.
Sorry to me to talk over you. I think my audio delayed. I got a hiccup.
My man.
Yes, Ren, this game is exclusively L's. They got all the L's that all of the other Mega Man W triumphed over and collected them, penned them in, and made this game.
We've done a lot of laughing over this game's bad translations.
Yeah, the English is phenomenal. How do you say "I hid myself to repair myself" in French?
Oh no!
Mm-hmm, lay back.
Let's find out.
What?
There's still one left. I'll go ahead.
So in X5, they ended it with Zero basically dying. Like, cut in half, shot through the chest, very much dead. And then in this game, like, X just, like, finds him again. And he's like, Zero, how are you alive? And Zero's just like, oh, you know, I hit myself to repair myself. Reasons.
Je me suis caché pour me réparer.
Brave, stop. I'm losing blood from my nose.
Never.
You're compromising my ability to...
Never.
Je me flatte pour me repère. I butchered that almost certainly. I'm sorry.
Je me flatte.
Oh, Ren actually... Like, put it in chat.
Yeah, I don't know if...
There we go.
I don't know. There's some interesting divergences between Quebecy French and French.
True, actually.
All I know is that both groups of people hate me for reasons I have never been able to ascertain.
What, because you're Irish?
I'm Welsh, actually.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah, that's that's probably the long and short of it. I just remember when I went to France when I was a kid, as well, like when I was like 12, I think. French just hate everyone, cuz, yeah, that's fair. I went when I was like 12, and like I was a child, and they were still horrible to me. Like when I went to Italy, the fact that I was young, they were incredibly nice to me. They were just very, very sweet.
Look at this nice little boy.
No, seriously, I had random Italian women like handing me treats.
Oh,
it was fantastic. We stayed, my favorite place on Earth to this day that I've ever been is Venice. We stayed on this tiny little island called the Lido with a family that would have people have their hotel guests for dinner once a week.
That's cool.
Yeah. But in France, they were just really not very, not super nice to me. Although I did get revenge. I did get revenge one night. We were having dinner, and this guy comes up, you know, the guy taking our order, knows we're English, so, you know, he speaks in English, and he's trying to ask if we wanted carbonated water or not, but the way he phrased it, he goes, would you like your water with or without gas? And me being a dumb American kid, start losing my mind, and my parents are looking at me, you know, trying to be all, like, cool about it. But I make eye contact with my brother, and then he starts to break. But we both make eye contact with my sister, and then she starts to giggle. And before long, the whole table is just snickering to ourselves. They must have thought we were so stupid.
We saw without gas.
Oh, whoops.
Oh, what the hell?
Like gaseous water, gaseous water, naturally.
Rekoha, sir, please hold the flashlight. Screen nuke.
Man, drop the fuck you bomb.
You have 3 weeks to live.
And I've never been to Quebec, but I have been all over Victoria and a tiny bit of Vancouver. And those parts of Canada are cool.
Get the fuck out of my castle!
Get the fuck out of my castle!
We have come for your frontal lobe.
Get the hell out of my office right now!
Hold.
Don't step foot in southern India.
Oops, somebody's crackling. I'm sorry.
I think it might be because...
To me?
Crackling looks like it's coming from you, Grizz. Yeah, sorry.
Oops. Alright, I'll leave, rejoin. One sec.
The little hamsters in the mechanical brains that run Discord. One of them got tired.
I don't know, a crackle like that sounds like a hardware issue.
It could possibly be a hardware issue.
Could be compression, could be hardware, it's hard to know for sure.
It could also be a skill issue.
Oh, stop.
There, it's like, computer has anti-bear racism.
Yep. Your computer is racist against bears.
Sorry to break it to you. That sounds better, actually.
Okay, cool.
Actually, I probably should just freaking... I kind of wish I could find a way to freaking bypass, but having the darkness is such a pain in the ass.
Yeah. So one of the things in this game, Ren, that is just absolutely infuriating is once the nightmare virus descends, which it has, it starts making the levels irrationally difficult. Like they were already kind of challenging, but then it just adds in like weird random hazards or effects. And it they're not like fun effects like make replayability there. They're like ones that like you like just like deeply fear.
They're ones that make the game feel like it's saying fuck you.
Oh, I chose yeah, well, dang it.
The castle levels, the castle levels for this game.
By the way, Sheldon.
Oh, so look at this guy.
Why does this have the fucking clam shells?
Because he's a shellfish.
I told you his name was far from the silliest thing about him.
Help! Thanks.
The castle levels in this game are the worst because they
dang it.
The castle levels are the worst because there's so much instant death. There's just instant death everywhere.
And and because I beat Commander Yamark, his nightmare is activated, which means drones fly in and cause multiple irritating things.
Yep. Why am I getting pinged for Survivor? Oh, they're doing Survivor again, and I didn't even... How long has that been going on? Oh, how did I miss that?
Survivor?
I don't know, how did you?
Oh, I missed a lot of it. They're having the worst Hunger Games simulator ever with, it's Republicans versus Democrats from political figures through history.
Gross.
Oh, geez.
Okay. Amazing.
Ford and Reagan had a small fight. Oh, I was so mad the other day because someone put Ronald Reagan in as a joke. And you know what? I can't even describe it. I'm gonna put it in voice text, but and then I'll read it out because it's difficult to even.
I will resent
this until the end of time. There you go.
reading that one aloud, kid.
Yeah, one night, Ronald Reagan convinces Kit to snuggle with him.
Oh, no.
Kit snuggling with Reagan right when they're coming in to take Reagan away for the fucking Watergate, and all Reagan can
That's
say
Nixon.
Is, someone's breaking
Wasn't that
in.
Nixon?
That's Nixon.
Oh,
yeah, next
fuck,
was one in Watergate.
Just figures they'd end up shipping me with old man Star Wars.
I am not a furry.
How would he even convince me? Like, did he just convince me of like trickle down like affection or something?
Yeah, trickle down affection.
By the way, are you ready for some complete horseshit?
How do you get rid of the drones?
Oh, there's just no hint that was there. I hate that. At least they didn't get... Nightmares didn't get them.
Yeah, how are you supposed to know that that's there?
Very carefully.
What you're supposed to do is, not.
I'm not gonna do...
He's trying to hurry. You should hurry through that one to save that guy?
Yeah. I think this is the body part of the blade armor.
Aiden's like, oh, thank God, I don't have to do drunk Dr. Light for a little bit.
Yes, God, I've been saved.
Yeah, this level's crap because there's just, like, no hints where stuff is. And I think you need to double jump to get there, maybe.
There
oh,
you
nope.
go.
No, there we go, we got him.
Kit lies, Kit's wrong, we established Kit lies. Once again.
No wonder Reagan wanted to snuggle with you, you are a liar.
Well, here we are around the campfire. Hold still, Jellybean.
Hold still, Jellybean.
Well,
here we are around the campfire. Campfire.
Here we are around the campfire. Let's snuggle, Jellybean.
Kid, how do I volunteer's tribute for this?
You'd have to join one of the most bizarre servers that I've ever seen.
Really?
It's run by Yap, if that gives you any... I don't know if you've encountered Shinominu.
Oh, what, the Shinomi guy?
He's not on Rick's server, and usually will only post when there's something like Thoroughly Contrarian he can post.
Thoroughly Contrarian, I see.
For example, his favorite House Pets character by far is Bino.
Bino, is that how you pronounce it?
That's how you know he's a messed up person.
I think he only likes Bino because everyone else dislikes him, and he can try and be the cool one and says he likes Bino.
Yeah.
I don't know, his affection, maybe that's how it started, but it seems rather genuine now, at least.
Well, yeah, he's committed to the bit now. He can't just get rid of it.
So I call this guy. I have to keep remembering. I have to be careful because one of the servers he's in is PG-13. So I have to be really careful because I call him Raw Dog. Because his name Shinominu. He was intending it to mean a dead dog, and at one point, as a joke, he changed it. He had the kanji up. And I plugged it into Google Translate, and he was aiming for dog meat, and it translated directly into raw dog. And I will never let him forget that.
Awesome. Well, now I know just what to say when I meet him for the first time.
It's also where I learned that CC actually knows a lot about Japanese language too, not just the culture and shows.
That was before we even started talking a bunch, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think we had exchanged because I remember. I think we had talked about stuff like the Transformers cards because when I got those around Christmas.
Yeah,
we had some idle discussions, but it was way before we were talking regularly.
I'll just try to come back here with a shadow armor.
Yeah.
And certainly way before we were dating.
Yeah, long before that.
Yeah, but it's a long time. He's got me watching all the Japanese, these insane Japanese shows, and the worst part is I actually kind of like them. I'm like, I want to watch weird lunatics in rubber suits punch each other on scale sets.
It's great.
Yeah, that sounds nice.
I don't know if I have High Max's weakness yet.
Oh, he is a... Oh, boy. That, yeah, because if you don't have his weakness, he's really... Your lame plan.
Abort your lame plan and tell Izok to do the same.
I won't take orders from you.
Oh, yeah. Right. I was supposed... Need to take the opportunity to increase the volume. So
yes, I want to hear what the dialogue is.
Yeah, because I can't make head nor tail of it.
Can you hear it good?
Yeah, I can.
Yep.
I hear it, yeah. Very loud.
It's very loud.
It's hard to tell with all that shit flying around.
This move.
I don't think it's in this move.
This move.
This move.
This move.
It's like they told him he needed to do like the anime attack thing where he says what he's going to do, but like he never came up with a good name, so it's like a placeholder.
Oh, that's him.
He's just got this move and that move.
This move. So that move.
I do not
this
have his
move
weak.
As well.
He is monstrous to beat without,
you're not, sorry. It's not monstrous. It's impossible. You cannot beat him without his weakness. Therefore, I have to die. Therefore, and I made a terrible mistake doing this, I now have to die 7 times.
Oh boy.
And even worse, if I try to reset the game, I will lose all my progress. Because I completely
dude, this game just hates you.
This game just hates me. I hate this game so much. It's so terrible.
Yeah, weakness blade. Oh, Yammer option.
It's Yammer option, Ray Arrow, and Giga Attack. That's it.
Yammer option is a weakness.
Weapon name is Yammer option.
Yamark is his weakness?
Yeah, that's what it's saying here.
Oh, yeah,
see.
That's right. I have to get him to... Oh, yeah, that's right. I have to hit him first with something, and then I have to hit him with something first. I forgot.
That's right. You got to hit on him first. Get his guard down.
Yeah, you got to tell him how much you like his weird magnet shape head.
There.
Hey, there all you go. Right.
This move.
I just don't know what else it is. Nice.
So when are you playing the Minecraft Mega Man X add-on?
The what?
That's
the
a thing?
Mega Man, it is a thing.
Oh, the blasters don't... The blasters don't hit him. I have to smack him with a freaking drone.
Oh.
Ah! Oh my god, you gotta see the GIF Haggis just posted. I can't post it on Zero server. Never mind.
Badness.
Damn it. Why? Why?
Doesn't mean I can't ambush you.
Yes, do it. Ambush me. Even though I will absolutely see it coming.
Here, I'll repost this on CA because I can't put it on Zeros.
Yeah, because he has another.
Yeah, that's it. That is exactly what I do.
Every Rick Griffin fan when West of Heaven takes on the female shape.
Yes. Yep.
Yes.
Rubies!
Especially me.
Yeah.
Especially me. K-9's
knees just turned jelly.
Yes.
No, he did. I will know the nanosecond Campus Avenue updates because CC will be on it.
Because CC will be just completely immobile for a day.
Yeah, no, he sees Clay's mom and he's like, it's brain go pudding.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
CC starts getting down into the trenches and starts texting Kit.
Yes.
And he's like, here, I know you're at work. Let me ruin any hope of productivity you have.
I know you're at work. Let me nearly get you fired.
Like, you work for Mormons, right? I got a good idea.
I mean, I can stop.
No.
I'm doing it.
By the way, I do have a question.
My damn phone. I don't use my office computer. It's my damn phone. I'll do what I want.
How would you both like to have a meeting in Kirtland, Ohio?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
I'm not even sure where that is.
Yeah,
history. Oh, my God.
Some history right there. Some history.
I mean...
Dang it, I missed my chance.
Listen, Ohio's pretty big. I don't know where everything in it is.
I tell you this right now, Kirtland, Ohio is where one of the big places of the Mormon Church was.
Yep.
Let me see where Kirkland, Ohio is.
It was before they got kicked out and had to go to Utah. Now, see, you don't know where everything in Ohio is. Utah's pretty big, too, but by virtue of it basically just being Utah, I sort of do know where everything is.
Yeah.
What sucks is that I'm so close to that.
Okay, so it is on the shores of Lake Erie, south of Mentor,
shit. Close, Ohio. Actually. That's close, actually. Shit. That's close. That's disturbingly close.
I've never been to Lake Erie. I've been to Lake Spooky. I've been to Lake Uncanny.
I've been to Lake mildly unsettling.
Lake Erie is like not very far.
I'm still trying to go to Lake Titicaca. Who would me?
You're making the pilgrimage to the holy site, Lake Titicaca.
I'll be there and like, why have you come to this holy land? And he's like, to be there and to say it when I'm there.
Titicaca.
Titicaca. You don't even need to explain yourself.
I say Titicaca.
Why have you come to this holy land? Like, dude, it's in the name. We both know why I'm here.
Titicaca.
Like, it makes me think of, like, there's an Animaniacs song about Lake Titicaca. The end. Oh, Lake Titicaca. Oh, Lake Titicaca. Because we like saying its name.
Yeah, for real.
Good night, everybody.
Dude, Animaniacs was fearless. Their writers would get away with so much.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Especially the original show. The original show was great.
Do you know why the original got away with so much stuff?
We weren't pussies back then.
No, Steven Spielberg.
Well, oh, of course.
Awesome. That helps.
Well, we didn't know anything back then either, though.
What's interesting is kids wouldn't even necessarily pick up on it. So, like, it was kind of subtle sometimes. And that probably helped.
Yeah, and it was pretty much also because Steven Spielberg's notoriety would help him kind of skirt around the censors a little bit.
Yeah, it's like, you want to run afoul of the Schindler's List guy? Go right ahead, I won't do it. Mm. Like, you want E.T. to show up in your closet?
Look at the stuff that was in AI, in his half of AI.
Yeah.
Oof, yeah.
That ship. They went to, like, the sex city, and that was basically... That was enough to probably make that film rated R if it wasn't Steven Spielberg.
Yeah.
True. And, like, just rewatching Indiana Jones, right? It's like, it's violent.
Oh, yeah. Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Indiana Jones like, got away with straight up blowing people apart.
Yeah, exactly. Kalima! Which is badass. But, like,
oh, dude, Temple of Doom is...
Yeah, I was like 6 years old when I was like first introduced to it.
No, it was. It's funny.
This is a nice family movie. Oh, they're gonna open up the Ark of the Covenant. Oh.
I mean, it's rated PG.
Dude, so my friends, Voli and Barry, let me borrow a collection.
I'm really sorry. I'll be right back. I have to use the bathroom.
Sure. Don't fall in. They let me borrow a collection of old sci-fi movies, which include, like, Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey,
oh, nice.
Soylent Green, H.G. Wells' The Time Machine, and Forbidden Planet.
Okay.
All four of these movies are pretty violent and deal with some pretty heavy themes. Soylent Green in particular, like...
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
you see some people like get fucked up in that film. Same with 2001 A Space Odyssey. You want to know what those films are rated?
I'm sure they're PG.
All three of them are rated G, and only one is rated PG.
Oof. You know, I understood
which one
was
rated PG, though. Real quick, guess which one was rated PG, though?
Soylent Green?
2001 A Space Odyssey.
Huh. That's
really? The only one.
That's the one I think.
That's the only one rated PG.
Interesting.
I feel like
that's probably the one with the most artistic value. Like, well, that's subjective, but.
Yeah, I'm back.
Thanks for not following
in. We had to watch Soylent Green in my high school film class, and it left me so profoundly uncomfortable. I was kind of like unsettled the rest of the day, like visibly.
Soylent Green is people.
So yeah, like, no, for real. Like, there's a couple of scenes in there that, like, still, if I think about, make my stomach go weird.
Dude, that...
Okay, those... Your stomach always goes weird.
Well, yeah. Okay, weirder.
First of all, kid, your stomach is the pinnacle of weird, but...
Okay, fine. Not the happy one when Brave's around. Not the one that happens when I eat, you know, anything. Yeah, just the one that happens when I see stuff that makes me like question like reality and the goodness of humanity.
I see.
Of those four, two, Soylent Green is definitely my favorite.
I mean, it's definitely.
I've never seen it.
It's definitely got merit, like artistically, but it's still just, I don't know, it just left me so unsettled. I don't think I could rewatch it.
It was, for me, it was the writing and the world they presented, because they actually did a lot with a shoestring budget to really sell you on the fact that this is a pretty fucked up situation. Like how in several scenes, our main character just kind of literally has to walk over heaps of people that are just kind of like sleeping on the floor and on the stairs of various places.
Yeah.
So as I understand it, they actually invented PG-13 because of Temple of Doom.
That is correct. That is exactly why they did it, because of, you know, heart ripping out scene.
Yeah.
So you had to talk to, like, the, you know, MPA guy, you know, movie producer association man saying, alright, let's, you know, find a middle ground here. Like, yeah, alright, anything for you, Spielberg.
Yeah, so they just, we'll invent you an entirely new movie rating category for your film.
I think my favorite is still Raiders, though.
Here's what I want to know. Is Return of the Jedi PG-13? Because the first, like, 20 minutes of that movie has a body count.
It's PG because we don't see, like, any blood or any people parts getting ripped out.
PG-13 also didn't exist yet when that movie was made.
Oh, that was right before that, wasn't it? Yeah.
Before that, yeah. A couple years before.
Okay. I'm just wondering, when I got a little older and I rewatched it, like it was one of my favorite movies as a kid because I'm weird. I thought it was one of the better. I like it in the original trilogy. I love the final thing with Vader and Luke. So I know Jedi has a lot of criticism, but it's always been probably my favorite, but of the originals. But I remember rewatching as I got older, and I remember thinking, I'm like, wow, the implications here are kind of heavy. Like, a lot of people getting eaten by a lot of monsters and getting lightsaber whacked.
A lot of people just kind of not existing anymore.
Yeah. It's like, hey, you got a nice existence there. It'd be a shame something were to happen to it, to like 500 of you in the first 20 minutes.
Well, I mean, like, if you think about it, of the original trilogy, the film with the highest body count is the first one, the first Star Wars, because an entire planet literally just gets vaporized.
Yeah, that's true.
And there's, like, no real ceremony to it. It's just, yeah, we charged up the laser, and then the next second later, there's nothing where a planet used to be.
That's one of Obi-Wan's best lines in that movie, though. It's really chilling.
Yeah.
Oh, so you know the interesting. Have you guys ever seen the bad lip reading song? It's Not a Moon.
I've seen Seagulls, but I haven't seen It's Not a Moon.
It's actually a good song.
Seagulls.
It's either I die against. It's either I die game over against Hymax or I beat him and we move on to another Maverick. I have no way of escaping this.
Yeah, this fight is brutal.
Yeah, lightheartedly my brain's just a little numb.
I'm so sick and tired of this fight.
You've been this moved?
I have been this moved a little too much.
Man's been this moved a little bit. Man's felt the this movement.
I this moved when I should have that moved, and that moved when I should have this moved.
Yep.
It happens, man. You know, that's how it goes.
If you this moved when you should have that moved, you're gonna have a bad time.
This move!
If you're French fry when you should have pizza, you're gonna have a bad time.
This
then I just goes right into the
It's something about bone. This move, followed by
kick the baby, kick the baby, don't kick the baby.
Kick the baby, don't kick the goddamn baby.
I actually was rewatching some really old South Park. Was it like last Christmas, I think, of all times?
Was one of those episodes the Joseph Smith one?
No, that's a good one. No. I was watching really old ones, like the one called Jubilee, where they have like Jew Scouts with Kyle and like Meteor Knight. Also, because it was Christmas, I watched Woodland Critter Christmas, which is just fantastic.
Yeah, that's like the best one.
All right.
What the fuck, said the boy in the red poofball hat.
Oh, jeez. I have the entirety of, I think, seasons 1, 2, 5, and 6.
There.
Get this move, bitch!
Oh, there you go. There you go.
Yeah!
I didn't.
How about this move, huh?
Nice.
I legit didn't notice that the freaking invulnerability thing disappeared when he kept using his attack. When he used the middle attack.
Ooh.
I can't believe Ghoster.
Fuck.
I can't believe this!
I can't believe this!
The man literally does that body. And he literally can't muster up the ability to have an emotion about it.
Yes, you were stronger and faster, but did you have three dragonflies on you?
Rip Rippin's streaming.
Calling you out, Mega Man. You gonna take that?
The Rear Crew is playing Escape Simulator.
Oh boy.
Well, I think we all knew X6 wasn't going to be a one-shot.
Yeah, it's absolutely not going to be a one-shot. With how bullshit this game can be, it's absolutely not going to be a one-shot.
Yeah, it's definitely not. I set it up on the schedule where I'd probably be playing this tomorrow as well.
Okay.
Yeah, but what sucks is that I freaking only beat 2 Mavericks. But I did unlock Gate Stage if I want to try and go through that.
No. Do I want to turn my head into paste?
Do I want to wake up in the morning with blood in my teeth and a missing household pet?
Maybe opt out of that one.
Do I want to donate my jaw to the Tooth Fairy to get myself a Mazda car?
Oh, so I actually had like a major like scare several months ago. I woke up and was kind of groggy, and I walked and I stepped in something wet and realized there was a big puddle of blood on my floor.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, God.
And I was trying to figure out what on earth. What happened? So I'm checking myself, you know, I'm looking, nothing's there. And then I freak out because I realize my parrot is there. And it turns out she nipped a blood feather and had just been kind of spritzing my floor.
Oh, God.
By the way,
yeah, it was bad.
Gate's little lab coat makes them look like it just looks so out of place on them.
Well, to be completely honest, I think him in the lab coat looks a lot better than what he becomes later.
Yeah, fair. I don't know, it's like he's got this still, he wants to be this evil, corrupted guy, but like, part of him still wants to be just this little nerd guy, just this little science guy.
The next time you see him, he's wearing the programming socks.
I don't know about this. Last time someone wanted, like, just the complete whole, like, ethnostate of one species, right? I don't think that went so well, this time.
It tends not to. It tends not to.
Yeah, funny mustache man kind of screwed the pooch on that. I don't know about
you. I'm being real.
Gonna be honest, the voice acting is the best thing about this game.
It really is. Like, they took... They took the quality of the voice acting and powered it with the quality of the rest of the game, and there's nothing left.
I'm also fond of the music and art. It's just the execution, just putting it all together, completely fumbles.
I did not defeat your investigators. I just defeat IMAX.
I did not hit your investigators.
I killed like two of them, Max.
Oh, hi, Gate.
So the stream's been going for about nearly 2 hours now, so that's about a boss every hour. Smiley face.
Yeah, it's because there's so much stuff to collect and unlock. It's ridiculous.
XP.
Gate is behind everything. Stop his evil.
We've located his secret laboratory. It wasn't very secret, it turns out.
Yeah, it literally had a fucking sign out front.
There is one thing I do plan to do off stream, though, and that's only for the sake of my own sanity. I'm gonna go back to previous stages that I haven't dealt with yet, and I'm gonna fight against then a character that's going to appear in the boss stages now, and they will just appear there. Because guess who makes his triumphant return from X5?
Bile.
Zero. Dynamo.
Yes.
But yeah. Yeah, I still have a minute left, so actually, I can have the opportunity to show it off real quick. I have the time. Where is
Dynamo? Without a doubt, the most fabulous person to crash a colony into the Earth. He didn't piss on the moon, but, you know, he does his best.
Actually, wait.
Piss on the moon!
Final countdown!
Hold on a sec.
Legally distinct final countdown.
Oh, Grizz, you didn't see this. There's a GIF I used the other night, game night, that I'm very fond of now.
Uh-oh.
Cheryl Hedgehog pissed on my wife!
Okay. And then he said his penis was it's big.
It's big.
That's disgusting.
How much money do you think we'd have to get to like do one of those cameo things and have Jim Carrey read Snapchat Eggman blowing up the moon for pissing on a moon?
Oh, Jim Carrey's would be expensive. Person.
No, we need to get Mike Pollock to read it.
That would be good.
It was like Dean Norris charges like 200 or something. It's insane.
I don't think we'd have that money.
Nah, I don't.
I want to at least make it to Dynamo. Because I want to at least show it off. Because I know, because there is like him talking at some point. I think he talks to both X and Zero. Yep. But
he asks them how they're doing. What's their favorite movie? What's the numbers on their mom's credit card? The exclamation date / year and the three wacky numbers on the back.
Yep. All right, there you go, Grizz. I found it.
Uh-oh.
Aiden like that too, probably.
Try all you want, bitch. You can't unpiss the moon as he dances to Professional from fucking Persona 4.
And he's doing it on the egg carrier, which somehow is even just somehow that perfect.
He
ground me all you want, Mom. You can't unfuck the Thanksgiving turkey.
I'm traumatized, Grandma. There's nothing you can do about it.
Here he is.
Grab. Grandma's still gonna buy, still gonna give me a dollar for Christmas.
So, Kit.
Yeah. Oh, I'll do Dynamo, yeah. Oh, you're very impressive.
Again?
You know, it takes hours for me to come this far. Ooh. I've been gathering nightmare souls at the risk of my fabulous, valuable, gorgeous life. I've been dying to become stronger. Do you want to challenge me?
No.
I want you to shut the fuck up. Because, like, you're kind of... Because you're, like, kind of a doo-doo head.
I want you to leave because I don't like you.
Yeah, I don't like you. You're kind of a poopy head.
Like, I can't believe they don't want to... I can't believe they don't want to hang out with me when I genocided most of the humans in the last game.
Genocide. I literally made humans an endangered species in the last game. And I'm quite proud of myself for it.
You are way too strong. Jenna. Smell you later, loser!
Yeah, he yells out. Jenna, which is basically, see ya.
It says Jana, Jane.
Johnny Jojar?
It's Jane.
Dejan. I don't know why, that just reminded me of funny.
I just realized I don't have Dynamo's weakness, so I couldn't collect Nightmare Souls from him even if I wanted to.
Okay, I want us to stop and consider that there is a Mega Man game that literally has the term Nightmare Soul as a collectible.
Yeah, it's dumb, isn't it?
As you do.
That's some Kingdom Hearts shit right there. That's some Final Fantasy shit. Why is it in Mega Man?
I know, right? It's dumb.
I don't know.
Okay. So... I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream here. It's been 2 hours. This game sucks horribly.
I'm tired.
Click here to claim 550 free Nightmare Souls. Now we have to do a PSA telling our audience not to click on any free Nightmare Souls.
Oh, yeah.
Don't trust hyperlinks from foxes.
Yes. We're all trying to scam you.
Whoa. Behind the scenes.
Oh. Thank you all for joining us on this stream, and we'll see you all tomorrow. See if we can...
We'll be around.
So we'll try hopefully our to pain get was... this gum.
Try hopefully our pain this... was some level of your pleasure.
Yeah. So let's go ahead and raid Rick Griffin real quick.
So...
You ever watch Rick's stuff, Chris?
No.
Oh, okay.
It's like us, but professional and with quality.
Oh, trust me, I know exactly who he is.
We know exactly.
Nobody here is more obsessed with Rick Griffin than I am.
Ooh, K-9. I wonder if Ren heard you say that.
K-9 and Ren had a competition for years where they see who can stalk Rick Griffin the most.
Okay. Dude, Ren is so autistic about house pets. He actually like made his own archive. Like he knew the names of like the first 10 strips that Briel appears in.
I'm sending it now.
I can't do that.
Oh. It sounds like Ren is the